Okay, so now we've created a working user profile API. We tested that you can create new profiles and you can modify profiles and you can list profiles in the system. But you may have noticed one fundamental flaw in our profiles API, and that is that there is no security applied to the API at all. That means that as it stands, anyone can use the API to update any profile. This poses an obvious security risk to our system. So we're going to fix that by creating a permissions class and applying it to our user profile view set. Let's start by heading over to Atom and creating a new file within our profiles API location. We're going to call this file permissions.py. This is where we're going to store all of the permission classes for our application. A permissions class is a class that Django REST framework uses to determine if the user has the permission to make the change they're asking. So each time a request is made to our API, Django REST framework can check the permissions classes and ensure that the request that they're making is a legal request. So that is that the user making the request has the correct permissions to make the changes they're asking for. We create permission classes by inheriting from the base permissions class that comes with the Django REST framework. So let's start by importing the base permissions class, or importing the permissions module, which includes the base permission class, at the top of our permissions file. Start by typing from REST underscore framework import permissions. The permissions module contains all of the base permission classes in the Django REST framework. Underneath that, let's create a new class called the update own profile permissions class. We're going to inherit from permissions.base permissions. So start typing class update own profile and inherit from permissions.base permission. Underneath that, write the doc string, allow users to edit their own profile. Okay, so the way that permission classes work is there's a function inside the permission class called hasObjectPermission. This function is called every time a request is made to our API. The result of that function determines whether the user has the permission or doesn't have the permission to perform the action. So this hasObjectPermission function returns a simple true or false, depending on what the result of the permission is. Let's define our hasObjectPermission class here. So type def hasObjectPermission. And in the parameters, we're gonna add self-request-view and object, or OBJ. Below that definition, put a doc string, check user is trying to edit their own profile. Okay, so the first thing that we want to do with this permission is we want to allow users to be able to view any profile in the system. So we don't want to apply any permissions if the user is trying to just simply view a profile. We do this by checking the safe methods list that's provided by the Django REST framework. A safe method is a HTTP method that is classified as safe. That is a non-destructive method. So it allows you to retrieve data, but it doesn't allow you to change or modify or delete any objects in the system. So a safe method is HTTP GET. We're going to check the permissions.safe methods list against the request that was made. And if it's in the safe methods, we're going to return true because we can allow users to view other users in the system. So type if request.method in permissions.safe underscore methods return true. So the request object is passed in when the hasObjectPermission function is called from our view set. The request object includes the type of request that was made to the API. This includes the method that was used. So we're checking here if the method that was used to make the request is in the safe methods permission in the permissions of the Django REST framework, then return true. Next, we're going to check if the user is updating their own profile. So basically, if this is false, so it's not a safe method, then we're not going to run return true. We're going to skip to the next section of the code. And in this section, we need to check that the user is trying to make the change on their own profile. So we know at this point that they're not requesting a safe method. So they're not simply trying to view a profile. They want to either delete, update, or change a profile. So we're going to return here. We're going to type return obj.id equals equals request.user.id. So what we're doing here is returning this comparison. So the comparison is checking that the object the user is trying to change has the same ID of the user that's currently authenticated in the system. So the object ID would be, for example, the profile ID. The user ID that is authenticated is this request.user.id. So if the object ID equals the profile ID, it will automatically return true. If the object ID that the user is trying to change does not equal the authenticated user ID of the request, then this will return false and the permission will be denied. Okay, so that's how you create a permission file in the Django REST framework. Save the file and thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next lesson.